All right, what we're going to do today is we're going to construct a truth table for a compound proposition with three individual propositions, P, Q, and R. So here's my proposition, if P then Q, or not P implies R. So the idea here is that, what I've done here is I've actually created the skeleton for the truth table, and notice that I have eight rows for the possibilities of the truth values for P, Q, and R. There's an easy way to figure out how many you're gonna get using the fundamental counting principle. For P, I have two possibilities. For Q, I have two possibilities. And for R, I have two possibilities, always true or false. And all I have to do is multiply those together to get eight. That way I know there are eight permutations. And that's a little application of the fundamental counting principle. So I've laid out my trues and false in the normal way. I have half true and half false in my first column. I cut that in half again in my second column, and I cut my second column in half. So I end up with four true, four false, two true, two false, two true, two false, and then true, false all the way down. The first column of this truth table is really easy. Now I get to put these in any order I want, but I like to break down every possibility up here, everything I'm going to use, every logical step. And I always make my science colleagues mad when I say that I'm breaking this thing up into its atomic parts. But that's the idea, that every component, logical component of this compound proposition, I'm going to go ahead and make a column for, so it makes it easier for me to come up with the final column, which is what I'm looking for, the truth value of the final column. So not P is, well, I have my truth values for P over here. So not true is false, and then not true is false four times, right? And then not false has to be true. Of course you knew that. Just saying it because I'm writing it. Now, for the conditional P implies Q, I have a little cheat sheet over here. Notice that the only time that if P then Q is false is when the hypothesis is true but the conclusion is false. So quickly I'm going to figure out where that is. Here's my P and here's my Q for truth values. Well, I'm fine everywhere except for the third row down, so I'm going to try to line that up. And that's false because you can't have true implies false. That gives you false. True implies false gives you false. And then the rest, we're safe with true on, as we learned from our cheat sheet. Okay, so we use this guy right here, and we also have already used this guy. Now I'm going to use the same conditional, but instead I've got not P implies R. In this case, the way I have them lined up, I'm going to have to read from left to right to find the true falses. True implies false. So here I have a false implies true, see, because it's not P implies R. So not P is on the right hand side here, so I'm gonna have to read from right to left. So here I have false implies true, false implies false, those are both true. Here I have false implies true, that's true. False implies false, that's true. True implies true is true. True implies false. Ooh, that's bad, right? So that's my first case of false. And then I have true implies true, that's true. True implies false, as we said, that's false. Now what's nice is I have everything I need right here and here to figure out the truth value of this guy. And I have the last part of my cheat sheet over here. And it turns out that if I have P or Q, the only time that that's false is when P is false and Q is false. So I can use that over here. I have this guy or this guy. The only time that this whole thing is going to be false is when both of these guys individually are false. So let's go see if we can find that. Wait, do you see what I see? There's never a case where they're both false. What does that mean? It means that it's true all the way down. And it's going to turn out that we're going to call this thing something special, but I'm going to leave you in suspense and tell you when we get to it what it's called. And that's the problem for today.